suit a rugby league and cups, you have to think they're the kings.
Well, they are, aren't they?
It's proved, isn't it?
Well, it's simple. You just can't, you know, it's just...
I can't remember how many times they've won it at Wembley, 20. Against anyone else, they're probably miles in front, aren't they, mate?
It's, you know, it was not a big ass. It was possible.
But
we didn't do our stuff. It wasn't...
We was nearly there, mate. We was near, so nearly there. At half time, mate, I was convinced we was there.
Well, I'm still proud of the boys and
you can't take it away from him. They put the shift in. And they never had any chances in the second half, did they, really?
Yeah, we did. We got a 40-20 and we still didn't capitalise on it. We got a couple of penalties. I've noticed when teams get penalties against us, they score all the time, Simon. We're not doing that. For some reason, we're not doing that.
Yeah.
Are we playing the ball wrong? Are we not capable of doing it? You know, I don't know, mate.
Well, that's... Our season built up to that, didn't it, really?
It did. I mean, obviously, your voice is a bit down still and everything.
I know. And I've seen you after the match, and me and you, we was both upset, weren't we, mate?
Oh,
but
yeah.
When I reflected, and we were talking afterwards to Marwan, I thought, yeah, we've done great here. Let's look at this realistically. We've pushed the top team all the way.
I've said to Kukash in the past, when I've had these conversations with him about him and the fans and everything, right, which we had about 5,000 to 5,500 fans there.
Yeah.
Right, it was absolutely buzzing.
Yeah.
The place I've seen people there who've not seen for a while, mate.
Yeah, I have since the '70s.
Right, but it doesn't matter, you know. And this is what we want to come back. And Marwan, I said to Marwan, you'll get the fans, Marwan, with success.
Yeah, success breeds the fans, don't it?
Correct. They will come back.
They'll come back, yeah.
And we will, you know. And I've seen all the comments on Twitter about, oh, where's all these Salford fans come from all of a sudden and all that?
Yeah.
Yeah? I'm telling you, I've seen with my own eyes that we outsold Wigan.
Yeah.
There is a document. There was a document sent to Salford by Warrington's safety officer on this, that, and the other, and Salford have sold more tickets than Wigan. Fact.
Well, I like the idea that Salford stewards was in the Salford end. You.
Yeah,
I think that was a great bit of planning. That.
Well, I'm going back to football again. That's what United used to do as well. You know what I mean? Because you know your fans, you know who they are, and
you know how he's going to behave and all that. But there was not an ounce of trouble in the Salford end, was he, mate?
No, except obviously for the we're going to go to the pint pot incident, aren't we?
Yeah, because I want to get a few things up here, mate.
Right. Firstly, you can't condone it.
No.
Right. It's wrong. And you can't do it, right? Because, you know, it's one of them. You just can't do it, right?
No, you can't do that.
There's no excuses for it in a way, but I will give you some excuses for it, right? Hang on,
let me read the letter out, because I put on Red Shark last night.
Right.
I put that word, you know, what Keith Fielding didn't like. So if you're listening, Keith, I apologise for that.
What word was that?
The W anchor word.
Oh, right.
Right, because that's what a Wigan player said to the Salford fans.
Right.
Come on, you effing wankers. Right. That's what he said.
Right.
I think it was, I don't want to name names, I'm not a grass, but it was Burgess.
Right. Don't you go on to the Old Bailey.
Right, it was Burgess.
Right.
Right, this is what Trevor Thomas said.
Who's Trevor Thomas, mate?
He was a fan, he was stood right in front. Right. I don't know him, but he was stood right in front of me.
Okay.
Because I was right where the incident was. That's why I knew what had happened.
Yeah.
Trevor Thomas, I was stood directly in front of the celebrations of the Wigan players, and a club professional, a rugby league player, made a closed hand gesture to the Salford fans, shouting, "You effing wankers." Now, that is not it. Now, if that's not an incitement, this needs to be highlighted, and there needs to be someone out there who filmed it, because he started the trouble, right? So this was another one, Peter Gunn, he said, "I was at the game, and on both occasions when Wigan scored at the Salford end, some of the players seemed to go out of their way to go to Salford fans. While I know this is out of order in some fans' reactions, in throwing a couple of plastic beer cups and one plastic water bottle, some of the Wigan players need to reflect on their actions," which is right, isn't it? Right, Marcel Lewis from the club. Right. "I know, I've seen it twice. But it doesn't matter. Every time we get dragged in by the RFL, it's always, we didn't start it." But they're not bothered about that. They care about the retaliation. Do you know what I mean? So,
yeah,
it was the Wigan players that started all that.
Yes, right. I think on both, looking at it from both parties.
Yeah.
Right? Firstly, emotions of the rugby player. He scored the try, he's put the nail in the coffin.
Yeah, yeah, last minute.
Yeah, boom, they're up, the joy.
Yeah, that's a Wembley.
But, you are professional.
Yeah.
You don't have to do what you had to do towards the Salford fans.
Yeah.
Would you do that in a Salford pub for the Salford fans? I don't think you would.
I don't think they would either, right? You.
So, some sort of, not blame, but responsibility has got
lies
to come
from with the Wigan team
on the players' actions.
Yeah, don't go on social media slagging the Salford fans off when it was you who caused it,
right? I think they're just taking the piss out of us, to be blunt, yeah, right there. But look, there's nothing wrong with kissing your badge and all that.
Yeah, yeah,
that's great,
you can handle that.
But to do hand gestures and calling fans
W-ankers,
yeah, or bankers, depends where you come from.
If Keith Fielding's listening, we apologise for the use of bad language.
He does, Keith. He's very foul mouth. But as a fan, I can understand that you've got beer in you and your emotions are going and you see stuff like that.
Yeah, but you don't need to hear that. Especially from a player. You have a responsibility to the club of Wigan.
Yeah.
Now, that player there, who I named before, Burgess, should apologise to the Salford fans, I think.
Well, if he was a man, he would.
But he's not going to.
Because they know that the RFL get the RFL say, well, hang on a minute, you're admitting to something here, aren't you?
Yeah.
You know, but there's another thing as well about the officials behind the line.
They should have seen it. They should have
picked it. Did we have officials behind the line in this game?
I think so, yeah.
Did we?
I'm sure we did, yeah.
No, I don't think we did. But even so, you know, linesmen, they see, you know, what they're seeing. You know, I don't know. They shouldn't have done it, but I can see where they're coming from.
Yeah.
And I can also see where the fans are coming from. And there's just going to be one solution soon. They'll just put a beer ban on Salford fans. That's what's going to come. I will mark my words, if this carries on, the behaviour of throwing bottles and pint pots, there will be a beer ban on Salford fans.
It's going to happen, isn't it?
We've got to, because it's, you know, the club will get fined for it, Simon. We're all on a suspended, which is going to be over, like, with the bottle incident with James Childs.
Yeah.
So that's going to take that, and then there's going to be another one. Where can we draw the line?
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
What have the club got to do, and what have been, you're just going to stop drinking in the stands? You shouldn't have to do that because of a couple of people who were upset. I get they were upset. I've been one of them people upset before.
Yeah.
You know, we've all done stupid things in beer. We don't mean it. It's just the you know, the heat of the moment, and it gets to you.
Yeah.
But players have to have and take responsibility of the actions of how they celebrate.
Yeah, definitely.
Now, if that's in their end and they score in front of the Wigan fans, do what you want.
Yeah.
Yeah? You can't do it on a way. Now, you imagine if that was the other way around and the Salford players done that to the Wigan fans.
Oh, they'd be out row, mate.
What would they have got? They would have got
they got 15 game suspensions.
You know, and you see on Twitter about Castleford saying the Salford fans are the disgrace and all that. Yeah, hang on a minute, Castleford. Weren't you the ones who invaded the pitch with witness and started, you know, with mascots
fighting
on the pitch and everything? So have a look at yourselves, yeah? Don't be starting pointing fingers at Salford and start, you know what I mean,
having a go
at us.
I've seen some right garbage on the Twitter saying about Salford having a bad minority.
Well,
they haven't, have they?
Listen, you get minorities anyway. When it comes with alcohol,
yeah,
right, and you've got different emotions,
yeah,
right, that's when you're going to get the conflict with it all.
Yeah, yeah.
Simple.
Yeah. People handle it different, don't they?
Correct, right? You know, but we should be doing things where there's children around and women or whatever.
No.
That, you know, that I get that point and it's wrong.
Yeah.
But it happened, and I'm sure the guy, but what a shot though.
Yeah, it is. Did you see how he went down? He went down like he'd been hit with an elephant gun. Watch how he goes down
plastic
glass.
He puts the empty pot on his head.
Yeah, he got a bit brave though when he realised it.
I think if you ask the player himself, no damage done.
The only damage was done by was Burgess with his hand gestures and his mouth in it at Salford fans.
He's got to have a look at that himself, and if he wants to apologise, he can, but I can't see it, Simon.
I can't, but he should be man enough.
Well, they're not, are they?
No.
You know, because you know that they'll get the blame for it, you know what I mean? Yeah. But anyway, but that's the majors. But I don't want to, you know, this is the thing, we've just been beat in a semi-final, and we're talking about plastic pot sitting people. It shouldn't be like that.
No,
but we was there a few years back when we played Warrington, and the Warrington players fizzed the ball right into the ground, and he got a bottle launched at him.
Yeah.
And You know, but you can't do launcher balls and things like that. Mate. You know, they got to have a little bit of respect and think about their actions. I get that the emotions of the player and they put the nail in the coffin and that. You know, this is why I always say to some of the lads who we go with, don't start singing about ex players. Don't start because it comes back and bites you on the ass. You know what I mean?
Didn't say it, Ellings, didn't it?
You know, and just for the record, Ian Archer, Rhys Archer, and Nathan Archer, use free. You know what I mean? They agreed with the BBC that Sam Tompkins was man of the match.
No, Sam Tompkins.
Get a grip, you. Ugh.
To me, he was only one man at match. Don't you say who my man at match was?
Who was that, mate?
Niall Everwolf.
You're not going to give it to the losing team.
I thought it was outstanding, mate. I've never seen him play so good.
You're not going to give it to
And you can understand why he's keeping Gaz O'Brien out of the team.
You're not going to give it to the losing player. They never do, mate. It's just the way it goes, but. No, I don't think Sam Tompkins went out. The man should have even got back on the pitch if it was a professional foul, like they're saying. I thought a professional foul was a red card.
Yeah, well, he bottled it. You know? Look, when it comes to a big decision, he went to the screen.
You got a lot of things right, Charles. I've got to give him that. But at the end of the day, Simon, he was under spotlight anyway. Yeah. He's under spotlight. He's on TV.
Yeah.
Worldwide audience. So he's going to have to be fair and square. He can't make himself look like a fool, can he?
No.
You know what I mean?
To me, personally, I think that's the best I've ever seen him ref, to be honest.
Well, like I said, and then he's going to turn around to the RFL and say, see, I'm not that bad, am I?
He wasn't, to be honest.
You know what I mean? But when there's no cameras on him and when he's doing what he wants to do,
yeah,
it's a complete different referee.
I know.
So what are you trying to say? We need video refs all the time at every game so the referee can, you know, get it right for himself.
Yeah,
you know.
I thought he had a decent.
He did. I'm not going to say I'm not blaming the referee. Right, we've done a 40-20. Tazzy knocks on. These are the things.
Yeah, little things.
They had 12 men. We couldn't score. We didn't score a point in the second half. And these are the things. What you got to look
minutes,
at? Exactly.
They had 12 men.
So we didn't score. So there it is. But I'm proud of the boys.
Yeah, proud of him myself. I think everyone who went was proud of him.
There's a lot of pressure off them now, so hopefully they'll be able to go on and play some rugby in the Super 8s and hopefully get us to Old Trafford. It's a massive ask.
Yeah, it is a massive
ask. But you never know.
You never know. Players are coming back from injury. Robbie Lewis back.
We don't know.
Flash has got to be nearly there, hasn't he now?
I think he's out for the season, pal. Is but we don't know.
Mossop's out for the season.
But these are the things, if you look back on the season, we've done brilliant.
We've had a great season.
We'll go again, we'll kick on.
Yeah.
But it's just like Marwan said on his tweets, he's hoping to see them 5,000 people at the Castle when we play Castle for the week on Friday.
Yeah.
Keep coming, guys. Don't let that semi-final knock you down, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And we gotta be a force again because it's there. I've told my man it's there, but we gotta be good. Your team's gotta be successful. It's as simple as Simple as Simon, innit? Do you know what I mean?
Should we go to a track?
We can go to a track.
Which one do you want, Paul?
I'm not bothered.
And the Stone Roses or something.
Yeah, cheer me up.